Page 64. The love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بعد بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد. In the bottom of the page, the issue that is mentioned here or discussed, the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is it truly love to Allah or like they have an interpretation or more like a metaphor? Can someone truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Someone, for example, he loves his family, he loves his children, he loves his parents, his spouse, but love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is this true? قال والذي عليه سلف الأمة وأئمتها وأهل السنة والحديث وجميع مشايخ الدين المتبعون وأئمة التصوف أن الله سبحانه محبوب لذاته محبة حقيقية. Allah is loved for his own self and a true love. A love from the heart is not like a metaphor. It's true love. بل هي أكمل محبة and the greatest and the complete and more excellent and perfect love. كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Al-Baqarah والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. You find the true believers are the more love that they have is to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وكذلك هو سبحانه يحب عباده المؤمنين محبة حقيقية. And the love of Allah to his believer, to his servant believer, is also true love. And we say true love is like the meaning of the love that we know. It's not like a metaphor. It's not like a figure of speech. It's a true love. Because when you say we are servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, servant and slave is not like me to be slave is like a slave to a master. No, servant to the creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the vehicle of this relation of the servitude is the love of Allah. And let's say, and the regulator of the love is the hope and the fear. You hope to be closer to Allah, increase your love, and fear to not make it, make you more serious and firm in the path to work more toward the love of Allah. وأنكرت الجهمية. And why are we saying that? Because there's people, they denied the fact that وأنكرت الجهمية حقيقة المحبة من الطرفين. الجهمية was a group of sect deviated. We have their problem in defining the attribute of Allah, and they are mulhideen in many of the attributes of Allah, Sifatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're denied the fact that this love is true from both sides, from Allah to his servant and from the servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. زعما منهم أن المحبة لا تكون إلا لمناسبة بين المحب والمحبوب. This is why they say it need to have kind of a reason between both parties to for the love to exist. Children and parents, or to have a reason between them. You cannot say for them like you love Allah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like, you know, and this is maybe they thinking like the people of the book, where they love Allah because of the gift. So where there's no gift, there's no love. You know, and that's actually is not love. It's like based on interest, and then the interest one based on such a thing is not a true love. قال وأنه لا مناسبة بين القديم والمحدث توجب المحبة. And then they get into the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying Allah is the first and then nothing before him and everyone else is created. So how can have a relation between al-qadim wal-muhdath? And this is of course is an analysis that is sick and does not have any foundation to be like a tool to comment or to reject the Asl al-Mahabba. In this page of 65, the author, rahimahullah, goes through those who be said from this, how they been claimed to be disbelievers, and they been actually sanctioned by the death penalty. قال, the first one who innovated such a thing is Al-Ja'd ibn Dirham في the beginning of the second century. And Khalid ibn Abdullah al-Qasri, he was Amir al-Iraq, he subhanAllah executed him in the day of the Eid. And he said, Amir al-Iraq at that time, قال إنه زعم أن الله لم يتخذ إبراهيم خليلا. Because when he said the love does not exist as reality, as truth, then that what result to what? That we deny that Allah can take a Khalil, a friend. And we deny that Allah talked to Musa عليه السلام. وكان قد أخذ هذا المذهب عن الجهمي ابن صفوان. And this, subhanAllah, the deviated sect is taken from someone named Al-Jahm ibn Safwan. And that's what they call Al-Jahmiyyah, is from the leader of this sect. And also been executed by Salim ibn Ahwaz Amiri Khurasan. And this saying, and this ill thought, it was then migrated, if you can say, to the Mu'tazila, to the Mu'tazila. And this is, subhanAllah, has been taken from the saying of the pagans before. Because how can a relation of love exist between a person and things that does not exist or does not conceive? When people, they worship stars, they study the effect of the stars, and they worship things that do not comprehend. So though no relation, it can exist between them. And that's why he said, those people, they were the enemy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. قال وهؤلاء هم أعداء إبراهيم الخليل وهم يعبدون الكواكب. They used to worship the stars and they built the temple for it. للعقول والنجوم وغيرها. وهم ينكرون في الحقيقة أن يكون إبراهيم خليلا. And they are denying that Ibrahim can be a Khalil or be موسى عليه السلام to be كليم الله. الخلة والكلام والتكليم, all of them are level of love. And when we say love, it translated into عبودية of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because loving is serving. Loving is serving. And the greater the love is in the heart, the greater serving. That's why, you know, loving other than Allah at a very excessive level, it turned into shirk. It turned into shirk. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Because the greatest love need to be dedicated to Allah, that's it, the serving. Because anyone who has that excessive love to any person, he will be serving that person, and it becomes shirk. And actually, you can see it, and you heard it in many of the stories. وَالْخِلَّةُ is a very high level of love. As he's saying, قَدْ تَخَلَّلَتْ مَسْلَكَ الرُّوحِ مِنِّي وَبِذَا سُمِّيَ الْخَلِيلُ خَلِيلًا. تَخَلَّلْ is get like penetrate into all the paths of the soul. And that's why the Khalil is called Khalil. And this level only can be granted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in riwayah قال لو كنت متخذا من أهل الأرض خليلا لاتخذت أبا بكر خليلا. If I was going to take a Khalil from the people of أهل الأرض should be أبو بكر. ولكن صاحبكم خليل الله. But your friend is خليل الله. So خليل الله can, the خلّة can only be given to Allah. Because the love penetrates the whole soul, then will be like someone, subhanAllah, fully serving the one that he loves. And in the riwaya, qala inni abra'u ila kulli khalilin min khullatihi. I'm innocent from anyone who's saying that, you know, there's a relation of khilla. Khilla, this hub, not friendship. I mean, the khilla here is a very high level of love. وَلَوْ كُنْتُ مُتَّخِذًا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ خَلِيلًا لَاتَّخَذْتُ أَبَا بَكْرَ خَلِيلًا. And in another riwaya, قال إن الله اتخذني خليلا كما اتخذ إبراهيم خليلا. And this أخرجه مسلم كتاب المساجد. Allah took me as a خليل as he took Ibrahim as a خليل. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم clarified that it's not befitting for him to take anyone else besides Allah خليل. And if it was possible, he will have then taken Abi Bakr Khalil. But does not conflict this with the love of the Prophet ﷺ that he has to his companion and to those who are going to come after him ﷺ. That's which clarifies for us that there's different levels of love. Example here, قال in page 66, as he said to Mu'ad, والله إني لأحبك. I love you, ya Mu'ad. وكذلك قوله للأنصار, and he said the same to the Ansar. وكان زيد بن حارثة حب رسول الله. زيد بن حارثة, he was like the very beloved to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. As his son Usama, ibn Hibbi رسول الله, ابن حب رسول الله. And وقال له عمرو بن العاص, أي الناس أحب إليك؟ قال عائشة. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was asked about عمرو بن العاص, he said, who's the one dearer to your heart? He said, عائشة. He said, and from the man, قال أبوها, her father. وقال لفاطمة ابنته رضي الله عنها, ألا تحبين ما أحب؟ قالت بلى. قال فأحبي عائشة. Should you not love the one I love? She said yes to his daughter Fatima رضي الله تعالى عنها. Said then love عائشة. وقال للحسن اللهم إني أحبه فأحبه وأحب من يحبه. And he said about الحسن, Ya Allah, I love الحسن. Ya Allah, love الحسن and love whoever love الحسن. And a lot of example of that. Therefore, the love that the Prophet ﷺ has to his companion, to some of his, to his family, does not conflict with the khilla of Allah, because the love is darajat. That's why also the healthy love that we have in our life, it must be inscribed under the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Taghabun, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu inna min azwajikum wa awladikum aduwan lakum fahdharuhum. Indeed, from your own spouses and your own children are enemy to you. So be careful from them. Here, Allah teaching us that the love that we have to everyone around us, it need to be within the love of Allah. Guided, structured, and governed by the love of Allah. وَإِنْ جَهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَنْ تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَلَا تُطَعْهُمَا. قال the ayah before it, for your parents, you know, worship me and treat them kindly and nice. But if one of them, they're going to be like struggling or striving or diverting you from me, do not obey them. واضح. And the holy healthy love subhanallah only when inscribed in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قل إن كان آباؤكم أو أبناؤكم قال إن كان آباؤكم وأبناؤكم وأزواج وإخوانكم وأزواجكم إلى آخره. Say if your father or your children or your brother and sister and your spouses and the money that you have and anything of homes that you like and business that you are always thinking of making it profitable are dearer to you than Allah and His Messenger, and striving in His sake, then wait, which is waiting for the punishment, wal-iyadu billah. It's one of the great threatening. And that is actually one of the scholars, he asked his student, give me the evidence of the obligation to love Allah and His Messenger and jihad in their sake, more than anything else. And it was in Surah At-Tawbah. And subhanallah, when someone behaves this way, he will find the barakah in everything he loves. I mean, even the money. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Al-Adiyat about the insan, وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٌ. الخير here is the money. So, you're not prohibited to love the money. But love it within, under the structure of the love of Allah. So if you love the money and you love Allah, then you're going to spend from that money in the sake of Allah. Not be stingy. يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفُضَّةَ. Those who make kenz, he loves the money more than Allah. Then you can build a lot of example of that. قال فعلم أن الخل أخص من مطلق المحبة. This is teaching us that الخلة is more specific, more higher, deeper than the love. I mean the absolute love. بحيث هي من كمالها وتخللها المحب حتى يكون المحبوب بها محبوبا لذاته لا لشيء آخر. So الخلة goes deep in the soul of a person, that the person or the thing that he's loving for, say, for his Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be loved for Allah, not for anything else. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test the one who loves him, he's elevating him. Why? Because to make the relation of servitude and love not based on what someone has in his hand. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qal, look the ayat, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. MashaAllah, everyone is reminding us that we have to finish the class. طيب. I will finish this thought, inshaAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qal, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ in Surah Al-Baqarah, right? Remember me, I remember you. The whole first chapter talking about Bani Israel, he said, remember my gift. I fulfill my promise to you. So Bani Israel, their problem of deviation was founded on only knowing Allah and loving Allah through the gift that they have. When the gift disappeared, the love disappears. What it comes in place, denial and ungratefulness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the believer, فَاذْكُرُونِي me, أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Make shukr even without anything you have in your hand. When you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, what do you say? الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. You still, you don't have anything. The fact to say Alhamdulillah, you have to say Alhamdulillah because you said Alhamdulillah. Look. Then what Allah, the next ayah said, قَالَ وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ. We're going to test you. With what? With increase of money? قَالَ بِالْخَوْفِ. Fear. fear of losing things. Allahu alaikum. قال بالخوف والجوع and starving ونقص and shortcoming and losing of money and anfus. And after that, what he said? Did he say, this is because I'm punishing you? قال وبشر الصابرين. So subhanAllah, for the love in the end to be for the sake of Allah, not for anything else. Because when you prove sabr, you increase in your heart the greatness of Allah and His glory. And that what increases His love. That what increases your dhikr to Him, subhanAllah. Then, subhanAllah, the test to take away from you, that is, subhanAllah, filling your heart. So Allah helping you to fill your heart with His love. And then to be away from the wa'id that mentioned in Surah At-Tawbah, that He said, قَالَ فَتَرَبَّصُوا. جَزَكُمْ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. Yeah,